Well, it's great to see everybody here this weekend, especially at all of our different environments, downtown Dallas and Fort Worth. How you guys doing? Plano. And also in Miami. Want to do also a big shout out to our worldwide television audience. Welcome to this time. The Bible says in Matthew chapter 4 these words. I'll read out of verses 18 to verse 20. Matthew 4, 18 and 20. As Jesus was walking beside the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, Simon called Peter and his brother Andrew. They were casting a net into the lake, for they were fishermen. Come follow me, Jesus said, and I will make you fishers of men. At once they left their nets and followed him. Today, Twitter is huge. And the big question is, how many followers do you have? In this context, it's not talking about a follow that's hollow. Jesus is talking about truly following him. Jesus challenged these fanatical fishermen to be fanatical in another way. He said, follow me, and I'll make you fishers of men. Fishers of men. How do you learn to be a fisher of men? You learn to fish by fishing. You fish for men. You cast your nets for men. That's the essence of why Jesus came. That's the essence of his message. He fished for you and me. We have an opportunity to come into his family, to be caught by the good news, by the hook of the gospel. When we're caught, then Jesus says, hey, if you followed me, if you're truly a fanatical follower, you too will fish. I fish a lot. I love fishing. I always get around and say fishing is a biblical sport. In fact, it is. Jesus was living in Capernaum at the time, and Capernaum was a place that was near water. He always seemed to be around water. He always seemed to be rubbing shoulders with fishermen. Most of the disciples were fishermen. Fishermen are visionary. Fishermen will face the elements. Fishermen are eternally optimistic. Fishermen fish. They identify with the fish. They think like a fish, and that's why they're fishermen. Christ challenges you and me, just like he challenged those ancient fishermen to follow him and to fish. When you fish, like I fish, if you really fish in the oceans, sharks will show up. I'll say it again. If you fish, sharks will show up. Let me stop here and add something. This talk today is directed toward people who are true fanatical followers of Christ. It's directed for people who have come into a personal relationship with Christ. I'm not talking about people who are religious. I'm talking about people who have a personal relationship. Now, if you have never established a personal relationship, listen very, very carefully, because you need to know what Jesus was all about and is all about. But specifically, I want to challenge myself and challenge every follower to fish. But when you fish, when you really cast those nets, when you really think about people who don't know Christ personally, sharks will show up. Now, why can I say that? How can I say that? Think with me. The gospel is all about the blood of Jesus. We're toast without the blood of Jesus. In the blood, there's life. Grace, forgiveness, mercy is all about the blood of Jesus. He died on the cross for our sins and shed his precious blood for you and for me. When we preach the blood, when we teach the blood, when we live out the blood is attractive. It's attractive because there's a fragrance to it to people who don't know Christ. Also, it's attractive to sharks. Sharks show up when there's blood in the water. Think with me to Jesus. You remember the sharks circling him? wanting to tear him apart. Do you remember the fins slicing through the water? What did he do? He got away from the sharks. Many times he faced the sharks, but now and then he got away from the sharks. I think about Paul after his Damascus Road experience. He became a follower. He was a guy who was persecuting the church. He was all about hating believers. Now all of a sudden, something shifts in his life that never shifts back. He has this powerful pivot point in his life. They tried to kill him, to tear him apart. Sharks showed up to attack him. He had to sneak away from Damascus. He got away from the sharks. Time and time again, we see people escaping from the sharks, and we see people facing sharks. When you fish, sharks will show up. Something else. Sharks can keep us, I'm talking about believers, from catching the kind of fish we want to catch. You're fishing, you want to catch a certain type of fish, right? We're fishing. Our lives should be about fishing. We're fishing for men and women, people away from God. We understand that. We know that. We've processed that. We see it. That's the message of Jesus. He started his ministry talking about fishing. He ended his ministry talking about fishing. It's all about that. It's about other things, but that's the main thing. When you concentrate on fishing, sometimes areas can be so shark infested that they keep the kind of fish you want to catch away. I've done that before. I've been fishing, I pulled up to an area, and there's so many sharks circling the boat, so many sharks all around. Sharks are smart. They know that inevitably you're going to catch a fish, this fish will be thrashing and splashing, then they'll eat the fish. So when I see that many sharks, I move. I move to another spot. That's what Jesus did. Too many sharks, he moved to another spot. That's what the Apostle Paul did. Too many sharks, he moved to another spot. Jesus one day told his disciples, if a city has too many fins in it, move to another spot. Sharks can keep us from catching the kind of fish that the Lord Jesus wants us to catch. Are you shark smart? Are you shark smart? You're a fisherman. How do you learn how to fish? You fish. That's how you learn how to fish. Start fishing. Start casting. Start praying. Start talking. Start inviting. Sharks will show up. Some areas, though, are so sharky, you gotta move. And that's one of the main things about sharks. Sharks are on the move all the time. They're moving. They're moving, they've got to move. If they don't move, they'll die. Well, yet sometimes sharks sleep. I've seen that on the Discovery Channel. Yeah, they sleep. The current, though, is running through their gills. Sharks are in churches. Sharks are in churches all over the world, and they move from church to church to church, always moving. We've got to move. Now, sometimes you're going to see sharks, and you just go, okay, there's some sharks. Because I would argue, a healthy ecosystem is going to have some sharks. You don't want to fish in an area where there are no sharks, but you can't fish in areas where you have too many sharks. When we fish, sharks show up. Sometimes sharks can keep us from catching the kind of fish that we should be catching. If you're not seeing sharks, you're not fishing. Some are like, well, Ed, I don't see any sharks. I mean, I don't see any of these things. I mean, I don't see a shark at all. I don't see any fin. I don't see a dark shape. There's no blood in the water. So if you're not dealing with sharks, you're not fishing. Small sharks grow into big sharks. Sometimes you see a small shark, it's like, no big deal. It's a small shark. I can handle it. Small sharks have the same character qualities as the big ones. They got teeth, they got fins, they got skin. It's easy to sort of skim over the small sharks. It's easy to sort of deny that they're there. It's easy to say, well, out of sight, out of mind. It's just a small shark. I've got news for you, though. Sharks quickly grow from small to big. Are you dealing with the small sharks? Are you confronting the small sharks? Are you praying for real stuff to handle these small sharks? You might be going, well, what kind of sharks are you talking about? This sounds a little bit weird. You're telling me to be shark smart, to be aware of the sharks. You're telling me that Jesus has commanded me to fish, and I should be all about fishing, and I learn how to fish by fishing. What kind of sharks are you talking about, man? You've talked in generalities. Specifically, what kind of sharks are you talking about? I'm talking about the bull shark. Some of us deal with bull sharks. People who are just full of it, man. Full of bull. People that talk a big game, but they don't live it out. People who sort of make you think they're a part of it, that they support the body of Christ, that they're involved in the church, that they're really engaged, but in reality, it's a bunch of, they're bull sharks, full of bull. Lemon sharks. You ever met a lemon shark? They're sour, man. Negative. Pessimistic. Oh, that won't work. I can't believe we're trying that. The music is too loud. I'm not sure about that short film. That's not my favorite way for someone to communicate. Sour, negative, lemon sharks. You swimming with lemon sharks? Nurse sharks, the classic enabler. The classic shark that doesn't want to ruffle feathers. The classic shark that when other sharks are in a feeding frenzy, eating up this person or that person, eating up this leader or that leader, they just don't really do anything. They're just sort of there, taking up space and taking up grace. Nurse sharks, bottom feeders. Their teeth aren't that big. They're just sort of there. Hammerheads. You ever met a hammerhead shark? That stubborn person. Oh, I'm not going to change. No, man. I want it the way it used to be. Because the way it used to be is the way it should be. No change, man. No change. We're not going to change anything. I don't want to change. A close friend of mine who's a pastor told me that he had the opportunity to see a young man 5 years ago commit his life to Christ. They fished for him. They used some creative ways to fish for him. He bowed the knee to Christ. And 5 years after, he became a believer. He walked up to my friend and he said, I want you to know, I'm leaving the church. He's like, you're leaving the church? You became a believer here, man. You met Christ here. You've been serving here. You're leaving the church. May I ask why? And this hammerhead looked at him and said, the church has changed too much. We've just changed too much. My friend said, wait a minute. We changed like crazy to reach you? You wouldn't know Christ had we not gotten out of our comfort zone and changed. And yet you're going to stand there with your big hammerhead self and tell me you're not willing to change for the next group? Hammerheads. I see them all over the world. God has given me an opportunity to travel the world and to speak to a lot of different leaders in a lot of different cultures, just by God's grace and mercy, only by the blood of Jesus. And more of the things I've noticed are all the people who are fishing and all the sharks who are attacking. kind of sharks? The great white shark. Some people are great white sharks. Ego and pride. They need to be needed. They got to be a part of the in crowd. It's all about position. It's all about that apex predator, man. The great white shark. Great whites will kill you. Nurse sharks can kill you. Bull sharks can kill you. Lemon sharks can kill you. Hammerheads can kill you. Here's what's so sinister, though, about sharks. If you're not fishing, you can't identify sharks. I fish a lot. And over the years, over the decades of fishing, I can spot a shark at a long distance away. Most people who are just starting to fish, they can't really tell if it's a shark or not. I can tell if it's a shark or another kind of fish that I want to catch just by its characteristics, just by the way it moves its tail, just by the way it swims and knives through the water. I can tell if it's a shark or not. Jude chapter 1, verses 3 and 4. Dear friends, although I was very eager to write to you about the salvation we share, I felt I had to write and urge you to contend for the faith that was once for all entrusted to the saints. For certain men whose condemnation, I'm talking about sharks, was written about long ago, have secretly slipped in among you. They're godless men who changed the grace of our God into a license for immorality and deny Jesus Christ, our only sovereign and Lord. There's sharks amongst us. And if we're not seeing clearly, we think they're dolphins, but they're sharks. How do you know if they're sharks? When blood's in the water. How do you know if they're sharks? Sharks are cannibalistic. How do you know if they're sharks? Just by the way they swim. Are you swimming with sharks or dolphin? As you're fishing, as you're casting, are you facing sharks? If you are, man, you're fishing. If you're not, you're probably not fishing. Not only do we face sharks, we can become sharks. Not only can I face sharks, I can become a shark. You can become a shark as well. Ed, what are you talking about? Again, I'm talking to believers. If you're not a believer, you can check this out, but I'm talking to believers. How can you become a shark? How can I become a shark? When you get over the grace of God, you begin to attack the work of God. You show me somebody who's gotten over the blood of Jesus, and I'll show you somebody who attacks. That is how I can become a shark. That is how you can become a shark, when we stop fishing, when we stop walking and swimming and leading and pouring out the blood of Jesus. That is when we stop. We stop. We get over the grace of God. We get over the fact that once I was blind, now I can see. We get over the fact that I deserved hell and now I'm saved by the mercy of God. We get over it. And we become sharks. Bull sharks. Nurse sharks. Lemon sharks. Great whites. Hammerheads. So if we're going to reach the people, friends, that we need to reach, we got to be shark smart. We got to get the sharks out of here. We've got to shark-proof our church, shark-proof our lives. Yeah, we're going to deal with a few, We're going to deal with them, you know. But if we have too many, I'm telling you, something's wrong. And too many people and too many churches live in denial and let the sharks swim, telling themselves they're porpoises, telling themselves they're dolphins, but in reality, they're sharks. You want to fish? You want to learn to fish? Fish. Keep fishing. You'll understand the glorious gospel. You'll be under the authority of the blood of Jesus. When we forget the grace of God, we begin to attack the work of God. I mean, fellowship church, is it about the thrill of seeing someone come to Christ, or is it about the kill? It's about the thrill, man. I want our church to be a dangerous church. I want hell to tremble when Fellowship Church gets together every single weekend. That's what I want. I want every demon to freak out when our feet hit the floor as we get up in the morning. That's what I want. That's what God wants. Are you fishing? Are you fishing? Followers, fish. One of the worst things that can happen when you're fishing is you have a fish on the line. It's the fish of a lifetime. You're like, oh, this is great. All of a sudden, out of nowhere, you see a shark. Follow the fish on your line. The shark picks up the thrashing, the splashing, the nervous water, eats the fish off of your line. I have a friend of mine who's not a follower of Christ. This guy's way away from God. I've talked to him, prayed for him, and he told me a couple months ago, he goes, I want to attend Fellowship Church, one of your services. I really, really do. And then he mentioned someone that he knows in this town that I know that I thought was a dolphin, but in reality, this guy is a shark. And when he told me, hey, I'll just call this person who is a shark and we'll come to fellowship, I said to myself, oh crap. Sharks. I've got to keep this shark off of this guy who's away from the Lord. And this shark gives the vibe that he is a full-court follower of Christ, but he's a card-carrying hypocrite dressed up like a dolphin. Got to be shark smart. Shark smart. People come to Jesus. People get hooked with the gospel. Keep them away from the sharks. Keep them away from the sharks. At Fellowship Church, I'm so excited that we've done that. We're in the shark business, man. Because we're in the fishing business, primarily. But because we're in the fishing business, we're in the shark business, and we have regularly, for 2 decades, shark-proofed our church. 1 Peter 5, verse 8. Watch out. Be alert. Self-control. Your enemy, the shark, the devil, prowls like a roaring lion, like a hungry great white shark, seeking someone to, say with me, devour. Say it loud, devour. That's the enemy. He comes to steal, kill, and destroy. That's the enemy. He wants to steal fish from us. He wants to kill fish from us. He wants to destroy fish from us. Knowingly, People are led this way and unknowingly. So the blood that once attracts can cause us to attack. May we never get over being shark smart. May we never get over fishing for men. May we never get over the thrill of fishing. Not catching. God does the catching. The thrill of fishing. The thrill of the pull. The thrill of seeing someone caught by the mercy and the grace of God. The thrill of someone being attracted by the blood of Jesus. The thrill of someone being cleansed. The thrill of someone being saved. The thrill of someone being rescued. The thrill, the thrill, the thrill, the thrill, the thrill, the thrill of fishing for men. Let's pray together. God, we thank you for this message. We thank you for this word, a word that I need. Because God, I face sharks, and every believer here faces sharks. But not only do we face sharks, if we don't watch out, if we're not alert and self-control, we can turn into sharks. And God, if there's someone here this weekend who's been attracted by your shed blood, by your forgiveness, by your mercy, may you make a decision, a life-altering decision to follow Christ. Well, Ed, how do I do that? You simply say, Jesus, I follow you. I turn from my sin. Say that, and I turn to you, Jesus. I give you everything, everything that I am and everything that will ever be. I give my life to you, Lord. And right now, you've been caught by the hook of the gospel. You've been reeled in. You're a part of this boat called the fellowship, a bunch of fellows, men and women on the ship. Become a part of it. Get involved. Tell somebody about it. Others here have been believers for a long time. Maybe you've lost your zeal. You've lost the fire of fishing. May we never, ever lose it. May we become fanatical fishermen, preaching and teaching the blood of Jesus, casting to those fish, moving away from sharks, becoming shark smart. Now, if you look at me for just a second, everyone look at me from all the campuses. If you prayed that prayer with me to ask Christ to infiltrate your life, to come into your life, I'm gonna ask you, if you would, to look in front of you, because there's a little booklet that I've written just for you called Next Step. It is crucial, crucial that you read this book. And also too, I would challenge you to tell someone about your decision. You've got to become a part of a ship, a boat. And fellowship, I believe, is the greatest church around. A bunch of men and women rowing the ship in the same direction, even through sharky waters. So become a part of Fellowship Church. And this booklet will tell you how to do that. Also too, some of you really, 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 because of this talk, you have maybe a renewed fire and interest in fishing and getting back to casting. You need to become a part. You need to get engaged in this church and serve and bring people to this place so they can be caught by the gospel. But you got to realize, you fish, you cast, God does the catching. And stay away from sharky waters, face those sharks, and don't you become one as we begin to discover the greatness that God has. We ask all these things in Christ's name. And all God's people said, amen. Amen. Amen.